हाय स्टूडेंट्स, JNTU के R16 फाइनल ईयर ECE सेकंड सेमेस्टर सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन यूनिट नंबर 3 लेक्चर नंबर 19 May 18th। सो टुडे आवर डिस्कशन सिस्टम नॉइस टेम्परेचर एंड G/T रेशियो, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ECE, Chebrolu Engineering College. So welcome you all for this online lecture. So based upon previous discussion, let us solve one problem, take snapshot. So a satellite at a distance of 40,000 kilometers from a point on the Earth surface radiates a power 10 watts from an antenna with a gain of 17 dB. So in the direction of the observer. So our problem first, so find the flux density at the receiving point and the power received by the earth station at a distance of with effective area of 10 square meter. One minute, try to think how to solve the problem. So based upon our previous equations, we have fundamental knowledge regarding how to solve this problem. What we have formula in our previous discussion. So we have the formula, some flux density, flux equals to PT GT divided by 4 pi r square. So in our given data we have radiated power now, that is 10 watts. Similarly we have gain, so how much gain we have? Standardized 15 dB gain. So that is the numerator. So this is the numerator divided by 4 pi into r square. So what is the distance here? 4,000 kilometers. So finally you got this value. So 2.49 10 power minus 14. Previous regular so try to identify power received by the earth station by the antenna at this point. So what is the received power? So from the given data, we have the received power equation. So what is the received power here? So this is the received power equation. So PR equals to flux density, clear, plus area, so effective area. So PR equals to F plus effective area, AE. But in the formula, flux density should be available in what units? Decibels per square meter. Clear? So that's why we have to express flux density in dB, W by m square format. So for such for how to solve this one, take the fundamental step. Clear? So f in dB, that is 10 log PTZT minus 20 log into R, that is the radius, minus 110. So that is the your value. So from our previous flux formula. So how much value you got? So you got minus 136.0 decibels per square meter. So finally you got F equals to minus 136. Minus 136 decibels. Now try to put this one. So this is your 136 na. So 50 minus 136, 10. So substitute the previous data from given solved data in the PR expression. So finally we got in wattage format minus 126, or in meters format minus 96. So did the conclusion here. Here we got antenna effective input decibels, which is greater than of your input data. So that's why here we got minus 96 dBm. So this is the one of the previous question papers. Take snapshot. Going to second problem. So next problem. Statement, the satellite operate at a frequency of 11 gigahertz. So the receiving antenna has gain of 52 dB. Find the radiated power. Find the received power at the earth station in dBW and dBm format units. First try think how to solve this problem, later take snapshot. Like our previous problem, already in previous problem we used the same data. So PR equals to dB. So already gain we have now 23 dB. Clear? So already we have gain in the previous problem. So by solving this PR, so we have ARP plus gain and path loss. Clear? So what is the receiving antenna gain? They mentioned 52 dB. So already in our previous effective EIRP 27 dB. Clear? So we have to calculate the path loss. So path loss equals to, what is the formula we have? 20 log 4 pi r divided by lambda square. That is here 4 pi value. 4 pi r divided by lambda whole square. So that equals to 20 log 4 pi r by lambda. So by applying 10 log, so try to substitute, you got 205.3 dB. So from this equation 1, try to substitute all intermediate values. 27, 52.3, 205.3. So you got minus 126. So minus 126.0. So that is the dBW fashion. So you got dBW. How to got in dBm? To substitute dBm, so this is the value which is greater than 30 dB. So simply add 126 plus 30. So you got 96 dBm. Very simple problem, na? 96 dBm. So in this way, very small numericals, formula related problems will be asked in the end examination based upon link equation. So how to solve the path loss. Clear? These were two problems are very, models are very important for end examination. So take snapshot. This is a problem number one, problem number two. Now continuation from previous lecture. So here we have design. So how to calculate the system noise temperature. So why? Because so previous picture is then equivalent circuit. So to analyze the temperature, system temperature, the entire circuitry of this satellite link design can be represented. So whatever be the figure shown on the present slide. So we have noise model in the receiver. So this is the simply called equivalent noise model in receiver side. So here we have noise temperature. We have here noise temperature of the LNA block. Here GRF gain for LNA. TM noise temperature of particular mixer. Gain of the mixer, noise temperature of intermediate amplifier, IF amplifier, corresponding gain of IF. So noise power at receiver output side. This is the equivalent all blocks in the receiver side can be represented by its equivalent noiseless blocks, which is RF stage, mixer, and IF stage. So finally at output of this we got power at the output of the receiver. So this is the schematic how to draw noise model for a given receiver. So take snapshot. that's why here we mentioned, so the equivalent circuit of this figure can be used to represent a given particular receiver for the purpose of the noise analysis. So what is the importance of the noise? What is the important parametrical values of the noise for a given circuitry? That is the information here we mentioned. So all noise devices which are presenting in the original receiver, those are replaced by its equivalent noiseless blocks. But we can't changing any gain or any noise generators. And similarly, these noise generators are be act as input to the each block. So therefore, those blocks are producing in the same noise at the output of the devices. Both our considerations are here taken off. But the second point here from the equivalent diagram. So entire previous main figure can be deduced to single equivalent noiseless block with the same end-to-end gain as well as the noise source at the input with somewhat of noise temperature of the system. So that is called here system noise temperature. So in this very important here, system noise temperature. So this system noise temperature has significance on satellite link designs, that the entire schematics are represented by its equivalent noiseless blocks. So to evaluate the gain compensations or gain values at the input receiver side, so single noise sources are be kept at input. So those significances are here simply called as system noise temperature. This is called system noise temperatures. So here we are calculating total noise power at the output of the IMP amplifier from this figure. So to calculate this one, so we have to add individual cascading stage. So this is the stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. So we have 3 stages now. So 1, 2, 3. So 3 stage side, here we calculated this total noise power. So that is here we have the PN, so total noise power. So first stage, second stage, so in second stage, so here we have mixer adding, and third stage here we have adding RF involvement with noise temperature of the input and RF. So we have here noise temperature of RF and input now. So that's, so first one is the intermediate thing. So that is the GIF KTBN. So that is here this block GIF KT BIN. Similarly, later intermediate stage GIF GM and your KTM BN term. So third stage add intermediate margin. So GIF GM GRF. So you can add some temperatures. So this is the total noise power at the output terminal of IF amplifier. So here these noises are very important. So that's why, so the input to noise temperature here, whatever we mentioned, that is here we mentioned noise temperature of the sky or atmosphere. So that noise is incorporated with the particular antenna. So therefore this noise will able to add some noise through the signal that should be amplified. So therefore noise radiated from the earth that will entered into the particular performance of the antenna. So in our starting of the unit, we have noise performances. Na, how to, what are the antenna significances in this noise? So that is how to draw the radiation pattern, etc. So that's why here I mention these three are the individual gains. Clear? So this is the RF gain, RF amplifier gain, mixer gain, IF amplifier gain, corresponding to noise temperatures of RF stage, mixer stage, and IF stage. So these are the corresponding noise temperature terms and gain temperature terms of individual blocks available in our equivalent circuitry. And out of this Tin term, that is the noise temperature of the particular antenna where we have to measure at the output side of the total equivalent circuitry. Clear? So that's why for the initial calculations of the noise temperature, generally we have to make these noise equivalent terms very much crucial for the signal path calculations. So that's why while doing some antenna patterns or axial ratio calculations, so these involvement of Tn is very much concentration required while simulating the performances of the antenna parameter. And another point here I mentioned, any part of the signal path that occur a loss by absorption of the signal energy that should be results in the thermal noise. So while this type of circuitries are operating, so already we have previous thermal noise is entered through the component of RF stage. Similarly, this type of ohmic loss that should able to types the path loss. So these are the main important of the significance of the losses available in the particular circuitry. So due to all these affected noise, so the main microwave signal energy is radiated thermal noise that is received by the earth station, whatever be the antenna attached to the earth station. So while this operating this entire information, so when this system is operating in fully functioning mode, so from the ground or from the sky atmosphere, the thermal noise is added to the given noise component. So from the same figure, how to modify somewhat of literature from the given question. So in the previous figure shows the noiseless receiver, wherein the each block in the receiver is replaced by noiseless block that should be followed by an equivalent noise source at the output of the each block. So therefore, what is the significance? So the noise source in the each case has noise temperature term. So therefore, that results in the same output noise power at the noise device that should be available to calculate the noise bandwidth. So these are the significance of the noise terms available in the particular equivalent circuitry. Clear? So similarly, from the same figure, if the noise sources are combined into a single equivalent noise, so with the system noise at the input of the receiver, so the total receiver is represented by a single noiseless blocks that should be available in the same end-to-end encryption. So here I mentioned some noise blocks. So that's what the total for a given total equivalent circuit. So this is the equation So that shows the significance of the noise power. That is, here we have noise power now. This is the noise power. Same noise power is modified into this structure. So to combining all single equivalent noise source. So when this whole system is replaced by single equivalent noise, so their corresponding power can be modified into GIF, GM, GRF multiplied by this equation. So KTF BN divided by GM GRF plus KTM BN divided by GRF, the KBN, so what is the TRF plus TN. So from the same expression for each term, so take KBN as constant. Similarly, both equations are multiplied by GM and RF. So GM, GRF, GIFN, KBN. So what is here? TRF term. From here, TN term. So from here, TM term. Clear? So from here, TIF divided by GM and RF. By taking simple KBN as output, common term. So from the same knowledge, here we mentioned two noise models of receiver by indicating same noise equivalent figures. So here noise model of the receiver with a single noise source, which is a single noise source, and the system noise temperature at the input of the noiseless receiver with the identical gain. So those are we here evaluated. Similarly, here we mentioned another noise model. So this is the noise model of a particular receiver with a single noise source. So the system noise temperature at the input of the noise receiver with identical gain, so that is available in the receiver side. So from this figure, what is from this figure? So we have to estimate the value for this. So the signal source of this noise, the noise system noise temperature that should be available in this total noise power. So that is GM, gain of the mixture, multiplied by gain of IF amplifier, multiplied by gain of RF trace, KTS and Boltzmann constant. So from by substituting this value from the previous figure, so we got this equation. So that should be from the figure number A. So we have KBNTS that equal to represented by this value. So that is the GTRF KBN, TRF TN, TM by GRF and TAF by GM into RF. So from the same, you have to estimate TS. So that is TS equals to here, TRF, TN, TM by DRF. And so this is the overall system noise temperature. So here from this one, so system noise temperature can be formulated by likewise. How to estimate the system noise temperature? So that equals to here, TRF, whatever equation here. So this is the very important relation, system noise temperature. So up to now, we have good knowledge how to calculate the system noise temperature for our satellite link design. So tomorrow, by the next lecture, we will come across how to solve the system ongoing functionalities of this system noise temperature, and how to solve the G by T ratio. So thank you for listening this system noise temperature, how to estimate the system noise temperature. Next lecture, we will watch what is the application of this system noise temperature and further topics detailed in upcoming lecture.